Hello and welcome to the intro video to the GDScript Fundamental Tutorials series. In this video, I just want to talk about the goals of the series, along with who the audiences are and the best way to improve yourself as a programmer. So the goal of this series is to build a strong basic foundation of programming using the GDScript language. Notice how I said strong basic, not complete. And that's because you can't do a complete foundation with just one series. The best a series can do, no matter if it's on YouTube or on Udemy, is give you a strong, shallow foundation. Now, in this series, there are no game programming examples, as in we won't be playing any kind of games in this series. This series is just teaching basic programming foundational skills. Basically, if you were to switch from GDScript to C# or another programming language, because you have a basic foundation, you'll have no problem switching languages. Now, the way I built my videos was to build a basic foundation because I read online a lot that a lot of people quit programming, whether it's basic programming for something else or game programming. However, I noticed one thing is that they quit because they don't know, for example, what's going on when they see a video. So my series is, or rather, I'm trying my best with this series to teach new people the basics of programming. The intended audience for this series is basically anyone that's interested in programming. However, I based my videos on the fact that I wanted to show and teach people who have never programmed before but want to get into the programming industry. My videos do go into basics, however, I try my best to push theories with my videos. Basically, theories you would learn if you went to college and took a Computer Science 101 and 102 class. So the topics aren't just shallow, but they go a little deep. The series inspiration for how it's built is a mix between Udemy courses, such as From Zero to Hero programming courses you may find on Udemy, along with what they would teach you if you went to college, which is deep, complex topics that you'd be surprised they teach you in a 101 class. However, with my series, I do try to mix both the shallow and deep topics into a middle ground. Now, the best way to learn from my series, and in my personal opinion, the best way to learn from any series, whether it's Udemy, YouTube, is pen and paper. Basically, take notes. And on top of that, when you learn a topic, read articles on similar topics and watch videos on similar topics as well. And it doesn't even have to be in the same programming language. For example, I'm teaching in GDScript, but you could also watch a video on C++. The more videos you watch and the more programming languages you expose yourself to, you may find that programming in different languages is really just syntax. Or rather, you find yourself understanding that as long as you have the basic foundations of programming, switching languages is as easy as just memorizing syntax or the way a program writes code. Now, if you do find yourself stuck on my series, the first thing I recommend is to Google and try to find the answers through Google. So after you've Googled, the second best thing to do is to post your question on the website Stack Overflow. And because this is a GDScript tutorial series, also post your question on the Godot Engine website in the questions forum. Now, I recommend Stack Overflow because when you want to learn other languages don't have a dedicated website like Godot Engine does. And so the best place to get answers to your questions for other languages is Stack Overflow. However, because you're using GDScript, it's best to post your questions on both websites, the Stack Overflow website and the Godot Engine questions forum website. Now, when you do post your question on Stack Overflow, also post it on the YouTube comments section. So if you are stuck, you can, and I recommend that you do ask your question on the YouTube comments. I'll try my best to answer them. Personally, I would recommend that you post a link to your Stack Overflow or Godot Engine website question and I'll answer it through there. I recommend Stack Overflow or Godot Engine because that way if other people were to Google similar questions, they may find themselves looking at that post. on Stack Overflow or the Godot Engine website questions forum. But again, please feel free and don't hesitate to ask questions in the YouTube comments, even if you don't go through Stack Overflow or the Godot Engine questions forum. Lastly, since this is a beginner series, if you are new to programming, the best way to get better is to practice. Programming is just like any other skill, and there is this common conception that to get good at any skill, you should be putting 10,000 hours. However debatable the amount of hours may seem, the consensus stands that practice will get you better. So, every one of my videos, I do have a GitHub project in the description for a majority of my videos. So after you watch a video, feel free to download the GitHub project in the description and just practice the topics you learned. Lastly, in this series, I want to at least help you as a new programmer get the basic foundations. The basic foundations will include literal values, variables, constants, along with basic control statements and how the control flow works for specific control statements. And on top of that, the basics of classes and functions. If you can get these four basics down, switching to other programming languages is quite simple, really, because these four topics are similar no matter what programming language you use. So try your best to understand intimately these four basic bullet points, because that is basically your beginner foundation, and with that, you can truly easily switch to a different programming language. However, in this series, we'll be focusing on the GDScript language with the aim of introducing you to different tools and techniques to help you get into game programming. Lastly, I do want to point out the basics of a computer programming journey. Everyone starts at the top, and that includes me. However, the goal, if you're serious about programming, let alone game programming, is that you want to get to a complete foundation, basically an understanding of the basics of programming. And that goes beyond beginner foundations. Because once you have a complete foundation in programming, you'll find that it's easy to get into other areas of computer science, such as web development, game programming, and IT security. Well, that's all I have for you in this introduction video. I hope I didn't scare anyone off with this picture. However, I also do not want to sugarcoat the journey of a computer programmer. Anyway, feel free to leave a comment down in the comment section down below, and I hope you find my tutorial series useful in your computer programming journey. I look forward to seeing you in the next episode. Have an amazing day.